Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the next episode of Euphoria. This is season one, episode six, titled The Next Episode. Very, very appropriate title. So last time on Euphoria was the Bonnie and Clyde episode, quote unquote, where we have Maddie and Nate, two incredibly toxic individuals that are kind of like meant to be, I guess, in this context of the show. So while they also have like a Romeo and Juliet type of thing going on here, where their families are kind of like divided and split apart because of this lawsuit, question mark, something's happening because of the principal found bruise marks, like assault, like battery markings all over Maddie's throat and stuff. And it basically all came down to, you know, they suspected Nate, but he didn't admit to it. We'll see what happens with all that. The dad is, you know, he's relieved a little bit knowing that his son is the one kind of like that brought the police involved into this. Because I think he, in his mind, he thought it was going to be Jules that ratted him out, which is why he puked before he went into the office, which was hilarious. Jules, speaking of, is being distant with everybody at this point, even kind of being a little bit, you know, having some friction with her father when he's trying to, you know, be like the usual kind of flirtation, not the flirtations, but the usual kind of like playful type of, you know, how's your day, you know, trying to be the playfulness that they have, that relationship that they have, the usual type of, you know, father-daughter, you know, just kind of playful banter, you know. And she would just felt like she was just kind of just didn't want to just talk about anything. She was obviously, she has something else on her mind, which is Nate and the whole blackmail angle. But I don't know what's gonna happen with all that. Kat is becoming more powerful at this point, becoming more confident. Maddie, we definitely got a good look at her in the last episode, like kind of seeing like how and why she is the way she is. Rue is going to have to kind of have to learn how to deal with life without Jules, because if her sponsor, Ali, kind of put it out there that you can't rely on Jules for everything. So, and with Jules kind of dealing with her own thing, Rue's probably going to start taking it as, oh shit, she's probably getting tired of me. So I don't know. So we'll see what happens with all of that. On the other flip side, there's like the rumors, which we know as the audience, this is true, that Nate had those dick pics on his phone. And Maddie is basically trying to blame that all on Molly or something. It's like, oh, I said a lot of shit, and if you spread any of that around, I'm going to beat your ass or something. So everyone's being messy in the show. This is great. It's good for drama. Love it. But I don't really know who to really root for outside of, like, you know, ironically rooting for Maddie because she's so such a terrible character. And, you know, the shitstorm that follows her is always entertaining nonetheless. But I guess in terms of, like, pure souls, I want Rue to get better. And, in you know, kind of, like, off of that, I want Jules to kind of get better, too. I want Jules and Rue to kind of, like, be that central kind of couple, that central light in all of this darkness that is the show. That's what I'm just kind of hoping for. But I don't really know what else to expect with this one. I saw, what's his name, McKay on the thumbnail. Maybe he's going to be starting rumors or something. This is called the next episode, so I'm guessing more drama is about to unfold as we get closer and closer to the finale. This season's only 8 episodes long, I see, so we're getting there. All right, guys, enough talking. Let's hop in. Have a good time. But before I do want to remind you guys, if you guys want to skip the YouTube highlights and watch the full-length, uncut, unedited reactions, as well as early access to everything else you see here on the channel, as well as exclusive reactions, you can hop right over to Patreon. Of course, if you can't support me over there, you can always support me right over here on YouTube. All you got to do is like, comment, share, subscribe to the channel. Now let's stop talking. Hop in. Have a good time. Discuss it afterwards. All right, guys. Here we go.
Christopher McKay's father demanded excellence.
I have a strong you think you are. You are stronger.
Great work, son. Just some water. Get ready for practice.
Ready! Hit! Hit! Wow, he was doing practice before the practice. That's crazy.
As much as he hated his father for the pressure he put on him, he knew it was because he was special. Because he saw something in him that could one day lead to greatness.
You get angry, you lose.
Daddy, he called me.
I don't give a good goddamn. Why do you think he's talking to you in the first place?
Because
he's trying to get a rise out of you. Trying to make you upset, lose focus.
Mm-hmm.
That's the world's game.
Mm-hmm.
Push on you, poke on you, see exactly how much you can take. And how much you can take is what will ultimately define you.
Mm-hmm.
How am I supposed to feel?
Like everything you feel. Doesn't bother you.
All your frustrations, your anger, your rage.
Put him in the game.
Bottle it up. You take your position. And when that snap comes, you let it explode.
The truth was, McKay was shy. But winning gave him confidence. He was recruited to play Division I football at the state college 30 miles from his house.
Okay. Good job.
He began to imagine a life in the NFL.
Made it to the big time. What happened?
And then he got to college, and he realized that everyone on the team was as good as him, if not better.
Damn.
When the offensive coordinator...
That's a humbling experience.
He'd find his mind wandering, trying to do the math and the odds of him going pro. And he realized 17-yard gain. He didn't stand a chance of going pro.
Huh.
But at the same time, he started dating Cassie.
Right.
The most beautiful girl I've ever seen.
And as stupid as it sounds, he fell in love with her. That's probably what was getting in the way.
Maybe.
And those fucking photos and that fucking video. He just couldn't understand how she could have so little respect for herself.
Jesus.
I mean... Even her mother said it.
I tell you, it's not easy to hold her attention. Like mother, like daughter.
But he also liked the way she made him feel.
I mean, yeah, she's supportive. Jeez, okay.
How she'd walk in the room and every guy would turn their head.
Hey, I've seen you around, but I don't think we've met.
Who's this guy? Oh, yeah. The guy that kissed her in the last episode.
They were jealous of him. Because she was his. Every time I feel good, I think it'll last forever.
Wow. You look fucking amazing. Thank you. I don't really feel it, but, you know.
Costume party? Hey, what the hell? Aw, man. Well, good things never last.
You Ted Bundy?
You're Alabama Morley.
Yes, I am. From True Romance?
Look, I'm gonna be honest with you, Cass. I ain't gonna ever hear the end of it.
Why?
In a bad way.
What?
Okay, so what do you want me to do about it? This isn't even a real costume, okay?
Yeah, it is. Straight up, that's the coolest Halloween costume I've ever seen.
Okay, so he's, yeah.
Seen with a fucking the telephone booth.
Thanks, Dad.
Kat's parents were out of town for the weekend, which was good because it gave her the freedom to focus on the important things, expanding her empire and collecting her motherfucking back.
You're so fucking worthless.
She now had four men that she cammed with on a regular basis.
Four? Oh, shit.
Hey, pigs. Point, piggy.
My dream in life is to bankrupt you.
And then, last night...
Oh, boy. What happens? I'd be so afraid I'd drop that shit in the... No.
Why, you fucking cool.
Wow. I think I'm gonna get really fucked up today.
Great.
Cool.
Aw, Rue, this sucks. She has to be like the sober one, quote unquote.
Wait a minute. I was supposed to be your chaperone.
I don't, like, actually need a chaperone. Where's Lexi?
They do look amazing.
Kind of hard to miss.
I'm Bob Ross.
I was about to say, it's like a, okay.
The painter from PBS?
Hey, creepy.
The whole point of Halloween is to look attractive.
No, it's not.
Oh, really? You do me a favor and you count how many girlfriends of yours are dressed up like 50-year-old men. Report back to me.
Wow.
Wait, did you guys hear about Nate?
No.
Nate had been temporarily expelled.
Are you gonna tell everybody about the dick pics?
First, Nate spent most of his days in bed.
What is that? A fan?
Then he decided to spend his days driving around aimlessly. Sometimes he'd check in on Maddie.
That's called stalking. I mean, I guess she loves him, so it doesn't matter, I guess, whatever. What are you doing?
Sometimes he'd check in on Jules.
That's stalking.
He met Maddie every Friday night at the motel. He looked forward to it every week. Maddie always made him feel better.
I'm sure.
And in turn, he made Maddie feel better.
Is this the Jules stuff? What are you doing now? He's so sick. Fucking hate this guy.
Is that Gia?
Oh, sister? Still getting high?
What are you doing here?
What am I doing here? What the fuck are you doing here?
Getting lit.
You know what I'll do with your ass later. Get up.
What?
I said get the fuck up.
Oh shit. I don't care. Time for her to go suck some. Oh, this. What a creep.
If you so much as go past first base with my little sister and try to get her high again, I will call Omar, I will call Marlon, I will call Avon, I will call Brother Mozone, I will call fucking Bodie, and I will call fucking Stringer, and I will have these motherfuckers.
The wire!
Or even Weebe.
100%. Oh, shit.
Do you know what kind of people these are?
I'm gonna get Chris and Snoop up here, man.
Bro, I think he understands.
I don't think he understands.
Tell her you understand.
Understand.
There you go.
Well, he would have been like, yo, I seen The Wire.
Run, Ricky, run, run, nigga, run, jump, nigga, jump,
come hit it, come run, 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 run. Oh boy, here we go. That's so creepy. He's just like watching her.
Like a street vampire. Can I ask you a question?
Why are you being mean to me?
What happened the night of the carnival? You just kind of like disappeared.
Ethan, if you want me to suck your dick or fuck you, just say it. Stop acting like we're boyfriend and girlfriend, because the chances of that happening are like literally zero.
Jesus. What up, Fez? Apology time.
Hey, what's up, kid?
Hey, man. Look, I owe you an apology.
Good?
For real, man, I am.
Fez is good people, I like him.
Listen, Rue, you a drug addict.
Okay, maybe don't say that.
Cause I don't believe nothing a drug addict said. Y'all just looking for an angle in.
I know, but as your friend, I need you to know that I'm sorry.
Does he think she's playing an angle?
You sober?
Yeah.
And how's that?
Boring.
Yeah, it's weird.
Mm.
I've been fucked up so long that it kind of feels like a new drug.
I feel it.
Yeah, boring drug.
Lows.
Oh, yeah. Real life sucks. You know what I'm going to be pissed about? I'm going to be pissed if this guy takes advantage of Cassie. Because he's already giving me creepy vibes. And she's already, like, she's already drunk and desperate enough to do something she's gonna regret, you know? I don't like this. This is super creepy. I feel like he's gonna rape her, and I don't wanna see that.
The truth was, Cassie and McKay were in a really weird place.
What the hell? What are they doing? Are they raping him? What? Do they actually, like, who are you texting? Oh, okay.
I mean, that's a fucking shitty ass thing to be pulled off. Like when you're trying to make love to your girl and someone just pulls you off. And what? Did they actually do what I think they did? You're angry now. So what do you do after that? Do you go to the police? Do you... What do you do? Play it off?
Are you okay?
Back to sex or what?
I can't believe they did that sooner, okay? It's so fucked up.
It's all good. It's not that big of a deal.
You have a shadow. Yeah, I thought so.
I don't know, okay? Like, 8 guys just came in here and I was really fucked up and weird.
I don't have sex anymore.
No, I mean, I guess.
Maybe I get undressed.
Damn. Now he's gonna take out his frustrations on her. He's gonna get rough with her and she's not gonna like it or something, right? Oh shit. He just needed to get some release or something, I guess. Yeah, she's totally gonna sleep with this guy. And there's gonna be a problem with McKay when he finds out. Holy shit. I just need your tender loving. When my time is up, be my rest. Yeah, me, it's my rainbow. Yeah. She's like, what the hell? This shit is so fucking crazy. And what's gonna happen to her? Because those pictures are gonna come back right now, right? Here we go. I can't wait to see this. I definitely want to see what happens next.
Holy shit, you're a fucking virgin, aren't you?
I mean,
is that why you want to fuck me?
But no, it's
so,
not.
So you don't?
No, I mean.
You do or you don't want to fuck me, Ethan?
I do want to fuck you.
Yeah, I want to fuck virgins.
Really?
Yeah.
This is so fucking weird to watch.
I like to fuck people that know how to fuck.
This is so weird. I want to see what happens with McKay. Damn it. I want to see a fight break out. That type of drama is always like fun.
Although I joy in me, I have no joy in this contract tonight.
What are you talking about? I don't know what that means.
Too rash, too unadvised, too sudden.
Jules, you're drunk, okay? And you sound like an idiot. Can you please get out of the pool? And maybe Ellie was right about Jules, because this doesn't feel good.
Stop, okay? Can you stop? Stop.
Oh. I guess I should have seen that coming. Yay.
I just wish she told me about last night.
Oh, God. What are you doing now?
What do you want?
I need something from you.
Nate, why would I do a single thing?
Because I'll put you in jail or on a sex offender registry.
You've already threatened this.
I don't want to force you to do anything.
Yeah, okay. What did he want her to do?
Yo, Steve Ray McKay.
What's up, man?
Have you seen Cassie?
Oh, boy. Well, at least they're not doing anything yet. Well, they are doing stuff, but I'm just saying.
I'm dying to fuck you.
I know, but we can't.
Why?
Because I feel really guilty about it.
I wouldn't.
This guy.
You're not turned on.
It's not about that.
So we can't have sex?
No.
But I can kiss you.
this is like driving me nuts.
I feel you up. So I can't do that. I can't finger you. I feel how hard my dick is. Come on. You have no idea how much it hurts.
Is she for real?
You're the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. Has anyone ever told you that?
Hey!
Lex? What's up?
Wash?
Oh, she went home a while ago.
Alright, yeah, because she's not answering my phone calls right now.
Oh, she's probably sleeping.
Alright, well, when you see her, can you tell her to give me a call?
Yeah, definitely.
What?
Not Ross. That's funny.
Thank you.
Hey, wait!
Daniel, come on.
Cassie. Look, I wouldn't tell anyone.
I feel really drunk and I should just go home.
Wait, are you joking?
No, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Who the fuck do you think you are?
What?
Are you being serious?
You think I'm here because I'm interested in you? In what you have to say, or what you think about things, as if you're so fucking interesting? You came on to me, remember? And ever since then, you show up, you lead me on, and then you whine about your fucking boyfriend. Any guy who says he's interested in you beyond just fucking you is full of shit. Oh, you're crying now. What else is new?
Okay, well, I'm glad nothing happened. But fuck him. Wow. And I don't know if I like Lexi. I mean, I get the whole protecting your sister thing, but that's wrong. That's wrong.
I just
Oh, mad motherfucker. You're like killing the mood. No. He already came. That's hilarious.
I'm a burden. Stupid, but it's true. So, oh, I'm sorry.
No, don't say that. What's wrong?
I think we're gonna head out.
No, it's just because you're not dancing with me.
I think we're gonna go.
Don't be fucking boring. This whole town is so fucking boring. I can't.
What the hell are you doing? Something fucked up. No.
I don't know, Dad. I'm not the best. I don't know if I'm not the best. There's no way I'm getting drafted. I don't know what to do, Dad.
It's all in your head. You let doubt creep in. Done.
I agree.
Morning, Tyler.
Oh,
this guy.
But one's better than the other.
Please, dude.
I need you to take a breath, relax. Then I need you to get in your car and drive down to the East Island Police Station. You're gonna walk up to the receptionist, and you're gonna tell her that you'd like to confess to a crime.
What's my other option?
Well, I mean, go about your day. But at some point, Madeline Perez is gonna go down to the East Island Police Station. She's gonna walk up to the receptionist. She's gonna say that she'd like to report a crime. She was raped in the swimming pool by a 22-year-old college student named Tyler Clarkson, who on the second night of the carnival assaulted and raped her again.
I'm not gonna confess to a crime that I didn't do.
Then we'll make you confess to one that you did. Either way, it doesn't fucking matter.
Sick, man.
Can I help you?
Yes. I'm here to confess to a crime.
Do you recognize that man?
Yes. He's the guy who assaulted me the night of the carnival.
Riley, we got a girl in 202 says she witnessed the Perez assault.
Jules.
And
she's going to corroborate the story.
He grabbed her by the neck and kind of like pushed her up against the side of the trailer. And then I immediately recognized that it was Maddie. And I knew the guy's face from somewhere. And then last night I realized where I knew him from.
A party.
He's the guy that hooked up with Maddie the night of McKay's party.
I bet she feels horrible.
Yeah, okay. That's funny. I mean, come on, Rue. You gotta put something together here. Like, huh? What's going on here? Every time Nate's around, she gets super weird. Okay. Alright, guys. So that was Euphoria Season 1, Episode 6, titled The Next Episode. And yeah, that was indeed the next episode of Euphoria. Nate is a sick fuck. He's basically blackmailed his way into getting himself off free. Now he and Maddie are now free to do whatever they want. So, that being said, what's going to happen with the rest of the season? We have, like, what, 2 episodes left? And I'm not really sure how we kind of wrap up a season-long story like this, other than maybe something crazy happens. Like, I don't know. Like that guy who turned himself in. Something happens with him. I don't know. Like, maybe, like with him and then the Jules thing, maybe, like, the truth comes out or something, and that's how we end the season. I honestly don't know. But it's just interesting just watching these characters kind of just going through their everyday lives, going through the drama, and holy moly, that there's so much drama in this show. And I can't even say it's, like, good drama or bad drama. It's just, it's entertaining drama. You know, like, I was just sitting there like, oh my god, I can't wait for McKay to walk in on Cassie and that one guy. Because I for sure thought we were going to go that route. Like, he was going to walk in, she's going to be, you know what I mean? But but surprisingly enough, she was like, no. She held her ground. I thought she was going to be weaker than that, but I think it was only because the guy was so much of a dick, you know? I don't know, because they were making out, and they were, like, grinding on each other, and even her sister was going to cover for them. That's disgusting. I'm not going to lie. And I liked Lexi, kind of, as a character, but now, something like that, nah, man. That's fucked up. I don't really like her anymore now, or not as much, at least, but it's just interesting to see where certain allegiances lie when push comes to shove, or when we're, like, cornered, you know what I'm saying? But it's just, I don't know. Just watching this always makes you feel, like, uncomfortable, but I'm entertained, but I'm disgusted, but I'm on so many ranges of emotions, you know what I'm saying? And I gotta say, I have to ask, why when I was watching this, or, like, while I'm watching the show in general, because I know the show is super popular, and I'm trying to figure out why. Not in, like, a disrespectful, but in a way that I'm just like, because it's so popular. And is it just because Rue, the actress, is, what was her name, Zendaya? Is it because she's in Spider-Man, like, she's super famous, and that's why the show's super famous? Because it's her? Because overall, I think, like, from a critical point of view, I think the show's solid. I don't think it's great or anything. I think it's eye-opening. It's jaw-dropping TV, but it's also very, I don't know, very disgusting. It's very, very dark and very twisted in who we should be rooting for and who we should not be rooting for and where we find characters, like, in certain positions. Like, I feel horrible for Jules. Because she was put in this position where she has to lie to the police to get Nate off. Nate, the person that she absolutely despises, so he can be off and be able to flirt and parade Maddie around like the proud husband and wife-to-be, or the proud couple, the proud Bonnie and Clyde couple that they're meant to be, or whatever. But I don't know. Let's just scrub through the episode, see what's up. Because I'm like, what else happened? It was like the Halloween party cat what's his name? Ethan was making his moves with Kat, but I'm pretty sure he came early. He probably got too excited while he was going down on her, which is, you know, it is what it is. McKay, I don't know what I really want from McKay, to be honest. I mean, I kind of feel bad that he was, like, pushed so much as a kid, only to find out that he's just literally, like, what was the stats? Like, one of 10,000 students applying for the NBA, or not NBA, NFL. What else is going on here? Rue stops Gia from getting high at the party. She has, like, an apologetic moment with Fez. Oh, yeah. I remember the Tyler. Not Tyler. What the fuck is McKay? When those guys came in, why? Why did that happen? Did they actually do what I think they did? I mean, they have to, right? And then McKay, like, felt super weird and, like, had to do, like, some sort of, like, power display over Maddie, which was super uncomfortable. Not Maddie. Cassie. Like, I get all these characters confused. Had, like, this power display over her, which I had to, like, turn away because it was, like, felt a little too rapey for my taste. And then she was, like, wiping stuff off her back? Was that supposed to be the stuff? Or what happened there at the end there? Because she was, like, crying or something? I didn't watch. I was, like, turned away. I just assumed he was going to get rough with her, but then she wasn't, like, screaming or anything like that. But she was crying, so maybe he was rough with her, and she was just kind of just, I don't know, cleaning up. I don't know. But I don't really want to go back and watch that scene. But I'm guessing that's what happened. You guys will have to, like, fill me in. I don't really like Lexi that much. Jules looks great in her costume. I feel bad that she was put in this position. The guy that Nate beat the fuck out of earlier was now brought back into play, and he's also put in an impossible situation where he's going to go to jail one way or another, confessing to one crime or another. So that sucks. But yeah, solid episode. I mean, it was good. I just, you know, don't really know where the story goes for the next two episodes, other than maybe the truth finally comes out. And I don't know, but who knows? All the walls will be coming down at some point. That's all I can really guess. So good show nonetheless, and I think I'm just going to end it there. Alright guys, if you guys enjoyed my review, enjoyed my reaction, you guys want to see this episode with me in its entirety, the option is available to you right now over on Patreon. Links are in the description down below or pinned in the top comment. If you can't support me on Patreon, you can always support me right here on YouTube. All you gotta do is like, comment, share, subscribe to the channel. Now I'm gonna get out of here and I'll catch you guys next time in the next episode of Euphoria, which will be Season 1, Episode 7. Until then, adios guys.
And if you liked what you saw, tell your friends, tell your family, tweet about it. And if you didn't like it, shut the fuck up.